During laparotomy, which of the following features is most useful to distinguish the ileum from the jejunum? The first option is that the ileum is retroperitoneal. Of course, the ileum together with the jejunum, both of them are intraperitoneal. In the small intestine, it's only the duodenum that is retroperitoneal, and to be specific, it is first inch of the first part of the duodenum and the last segment of the last part of the duodenum are in fact intraperitoneal, but most of the duodenum, the C-shape of the duodenum, is retroperitoneal. So the ileum is intraperitoneal, and you can see here the mesentery of the ileum. It is the mesentery of the small intestine, continuation of the mesentery of the small intestine. The ileum, the second choice, the ileum has omental appendices. The omental appendices are finger-like processes that contain storage of fat, and these omental appendices are in fact a characteristic feature of the colon. They are not present in the small intestine. So this option is wrong. The ileum has thicker walls compared with the jejunum. In fact, the ileum has thinner walls compared with the jejunum, and this can be felt during surgery. So the jejunum is thicker than the ileum, and this is because of the fact that the inside, the mucosa of the jejunum, is more folded. You can see here the plicae circularis in a capsule endoscopy. There are more numerous plicae circularis in the jejunum, while they become less numerous in the ileum. Of course, there is a gradual reduction in the amount or the density of these plicae circularis. So the picture in here shows the terminal ileum with the minimum amount of the plicae circularis. And because of the extensive amount of the plicae circularis in the jejunum becomes thick, and the mucous membrane can be felt through the muscle wall during surgery as a shirt sleeve felt through a coat sleeve. The fourth option, the ileum is suspended by suspensory ligament of Treitz. This is wrong as well. The ligament of Treitz actually, it suspends the small intestine at the duodeno-jejunal junction. The duodeno-jejunal flexure is supported by this suspensory ligament. Sometimes it contains muscle fibers, and it is connected at the right crus of the diaphragm. Its contraction, particularly if it contains muscle fibers, the contraction widens the angle of the duodeno-jejunal flexure and facilitate movements of the intestinal contents. So it is connected at the junction of the duodenum and jejunum and has no relation to the ileum, and D is wrong. The last option, E, the ileum has numerous or more numerous vascular arcades compared with the jejunum, and this is right. You can see here the vascular arcades. There are multiple arcades in the blood vessels of the small intestine. So you can see here that here's another arcade in here. So the vasa recta in here, the straight vessels are short because of the presence of these multiple arcades. They approach the mesenteric border of the small intestine, and so the vasa recta will become short. If we compare it here with the arcades of the jejunum, you can see that there are less arcades. See, less arcades, and so the arcades are away from the mesenteric border of the jejunum, and the vasa recta will become long. And so the option E is correct. The ileum has more arcades compared with that of the jejunum.